Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. In today's concept of digital signal processing lab, we'll be covering an important concept of commutative property of convolution using Octave software. This is the second session on Octave software. I am Madhav Skandirao, assistant professor, department of ENC from Gosek College of Engineering. Before going to the detail, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon for further notification, or go to description for further information. In today's class, we'll be covering an important properties of convolution, that is commutative property for the two given sequence x1 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, x2 is equal to 1, 1, 1, 1. The commutative property definition is given as x1 of n multiplied with x2 of n, which is equal to x2 of n multiplied with x1 of n. Now let us write the math program in a simple step and just execute and check it out. X1 is given as 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, X2 is equal to 1, 1, 1, 1. Okay, now LHS is equal to convolution of X1, comma X2. So this gives the LHS value. Similarly, RHS is equal to convolution is a keyword in a MATLAB, as we already seen, x2 comma x1. So this is the RHS definition what we have there. Okay, now let us execute this simple step. This four line gives us the result of this commutative property of a convolution there. Let us see. So file, save and run. So what happens, we have to just save the file there. Okay, we can give the name as commutative underscore convolution dot yum. Save. Now what happens? The result is executed. Let us see the results. So if you can observe here, we have got the result. X1 is given as 1, 2, 3, 4. X2 is given as 1, 1, 1, 1. After the convolution operation, we can observe LHS 1, 3, 6, 10, 9, 7, 4. Similarly, the convolution of operation at the right hand side is 1, 3, 6, 10, 9, 7, 4. We can observe that we have got the result of a commutative property here. Okay, that proves the commutative property of a convolution. But let us display this particular property using the graph there. Now, to display the graph, let us find the length. Let us take it as N1 is equal to length, L-E-N-G-T, length of LHS. We're just increasing complexity of writing the program. And then let us find the index K1 is equal to 0 colon 1 colon N1 minus 1. That's the definition of a convolution there. The same thing we have to go for N2 is equal to length, L-E-N-G-T-H, length of LHS, RHS. Then we have to take the index of index of K2 is equal to 0 colon 1 colon N2 minus 1. So that definition of a index for RHS there. Now let us display that subplot. Two rows, one column, figure one. Why? Means we have LHS and RHS, two figures we want to display. Okay, now for that, let us take it as stem for a discrete signal there. So what we want to display, index of first figure, that is LHS, K1 comma LHS. Okay. Then we can assign the labels, X label as LHS index values. Then Y label as amplitude value of LHS, left hand side. Then title, in single quotation we have to write, title is commutative property, LHS commutative property, LHS. Okay, so this is for the LHS what we are just doing. We can copy the same thing and convert it to the RHS. okay, RHS, here K1 will become K2. Okay, this figure 1 will become figure 2 there, and wherever LHS is there, make it as RHS. RHS, RHS, RHS. So if you observe that subplot, figure 2 for RHS, index values we have taken is K2 there, and we have given the labels for the right hand side also there. Okay, so now we have just added this few statement just to see the result graphical notation. Okay, now to check the graphical notation, we can go for run, save and run once again. Okay, now if there is no error, we'll get the figure window. Okay, now you can observe in this figure window, we have got the commutative property of LHS as a label there, LHS index value, amplitude value of LHS there. And here if you observe commutative property of RHS, RHS index values and amplitude of value of RHS. Now you can observe the figure both are same. Okay, this shows the graphical representation of commutative property, which we are verifying it. Okay, now we can further verify with the help of a single step. We can further verify it with the help of single steps. Okay, in this octave window, that's the octave software. Let us see how to check a single step. Go to the debug. Debug. Here we have a single step. Click on this. Once you click on the single step, it is going for X1 there. Go to the debug. Observe what we have to click. F10 for single step execution there. Okay. Now the pointer is pointing to the first line there. Now go to the command window. Okay. And now you press F10. We'll just see the single step execution. Now I'm pressing F10. Observe, we got X1 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. X2 is 1, 1, 1, 1. Observe LHS, the convolution operation, 1, 3, 6, 10, 9, 7, 4, which you already seen it. Now here I'm just showing N1 is length. So length is how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So N1, we got 7. So index value of that particular representation is varying from 0 to N minus 1, that is 6. 7 minus 1 is 6. So similarly, when you run F10 once again, the RHS value is getting. So observe LHS and RHS values are same. So let us see the length of RHS. N2 is 7. Index value is also 7 there. Okay. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell icon for further notification, or go to the description for further information there. Thank you.